Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the ESL One. I'm your host, Toby One, bringing you our third game of the night. With Fnatic going up against Cloud9, the winner of this best of five will get themselves a free pass to ESL One Frankfurt, who will be there live in the Commerzbank Arena. We're going to find out there over the course of possibly three more games as we get ourselves into game number three. I am joined my entire evening tonight by our expert commentator, Luminous. Game number three is up, and we get something we haven't seen since game number one of Dog. 5 seconds remaining. The Naga Siren slips through.
It's been a while. Now, you don't know for sure whether this is going to be your standard carry Naga, because AUI plays a very mean support Naga as well. Back in the days, they used to use Song to set up arrows from Sing Sing. So it still could be that, but it's a high likelihood that we're going to see Envy handle the Naga, most likely mid, go for a Radiance, and then go from there.
That would be one way of doing it. But hey, you're right, man. We can keep things mixed up. You don't have to just put yourself into one set path. I want to say something because I saw the question come out in the chat and I realized I haven't actually answered that one this evening tonight. Dota TV tickets for ESL 1. We had everything ready. In fact, our compendium was written about 2 weeks ago. Completely done. All information is inside of it. We are just waiting for Valve to release the patch with the compendium. With everything else. The games are free in the meantime on Dota TV as long as you can find it. It won't be under the ticket, but it will be there. But you'll have the American qualifiers, which begin in 2 days' time. Actually, I believe they even start tomorrow now. And the rest of the European playoffs in there, and the main event, and the Chinese qualifier, and the following up Southeast Asia qualifier will all still be on the Dota TV ticket. So please definitely support. When you see the patch come out, please go in there, buy the compendium for ESL 1, and bring up the prize pool from $150,000 courtesy of ESL and all the awesome people who are getting involved in the ESL. It's going to be great. It's going to be a party at the land, man. It's going to be a party at the land. You're going to have cosplay people left. You're going to have cosplay people right. We're going to have professional players down the middle. It's going to be great.
Good day of Dota. Good weekend of Dota.
Yeah. Saturday and Sunday. Where else would you rather be? Nowhere. Like, literally nowhere. All right. Game's getting a little bit further in, man. Mirana and Tree come up here for Fnatic, while the Darkseer is in here for Cloud9. ES is the first been out by Fly, and I'm pretty sure the Enigma or Disruptor will be the follow-up ban from this one. That Cloud9 teamfight is starting to look a little scary. And with Centaur still in the mix too, we've got a Hoof Stomp combo, which is also capable of coming into this. I know Darkseer as well as Centaur in the same game is a little bit off, but at this point, I'm just looking at possibilities.
Empire did it yesterday, remember? It was the vacuum hoof stomp combo, which did actually hold them in the game for a while. Mm-hmm. For Fnatic, though, Tree and Protector, No Tail plays it very differently from others. He goes offensive trialing Tree with boots first, because when there's a boots on a tree running at you, not many other supports could trade with him.
Naga Siren definitely couldn't. Naga would lose her life points almost instantly. If you get Leash Seated, you can't run away from that.
She does have six armor. So that helps.
She does. She does. But when you're elite seated up, if you actually have Mirana and Tree down there,
you can straight up die.
Yeah. Bane as well as Invoke would be the last two banners that'd be by Fnatic. I think Fnatic realized that no matter what they did right now, they couldn't stop the combination from Cloud9. They could pick up the Enigma themselves, which would get very, very greedy, at which point you wouldn't run an aggro tree. You would run like Mirana in the mid or Mirana on the safe lane and then get yourself a standard offlaner. Because then you're getting like fully greedy, you're just going inside the jungle. At which point Cloud9 could do exactly the same kind of thing. But they could do it with an Enchantress or a Chen behind them. In this game though, I'm pretty sure C9, they're staring down the Enigma pick.
Yeah, I think Tree also, in its own ways, is already quite good in terms of stopping that wombo combo. Because if he's quite far away from the vacuum, let's say we saw, I think, yesterday Relax was trying to do that, right? You get a Blink Dagger, you come in.
But he was so far back in that engagement. It's all about like knowing just how far away you've got to be. And if there's any kind of like global kind of damage that can hit you, if you're in, like even if you're in, actually, I suppose when you're in Viz, you're okay. Spectre will be a way around that. Zeus might be another way around that.
The Naga illusions with Radiance. I mean, if you're unlucky, in Viz or not, you're going to get a Blink Dagger canceled. So and here we go. We're going to see a Disruptor from Fnatic.
Yeah, this is... It's a semi-block pick, and it's also a nice little one to have up against a hero like a Darkseer. Problem is, though, for Fnatic, it's really difficult to come online with that Disruptor until you hit level 3. And that's when Darkseer just has to make the most out of it. Like, get his point up in Surge, get the 2 points up in Iron Shell, so if he does get dragged back, he can just turn and try and fight.
Yeah, I think that's going to give Bone 7 a little bit of hardship on the top lane. If it's going to be a defensive try, there's a very easy chance that Fnatic goes offensive with it, because Thunderstrike, one of the more damaging level 1 nukes. You add an arrow and Leech Seed on that, and that could be easy kill, but Cloud9 going back for a Crystal Maiden. Haven't seen too much of her. Well, Misery, I guess, played it yesterday, but as of late, I don't think we see a lot of CMs.
No, we don't. It's a rough world for a CM to be in. And you're never really able to control up your own jungle either with the Crystal Maiden, because you get like these Ancient Apparition like packs come through early on and nail you out. So if you're really going to put
Centaur,
that much...
That just one-shots you in the middle of the game.
Yeah. I'm actually more interested to see what happens now with Cloud9, because normally when you see a CM, you wouldn't say, well, they're going to run a jungle hero as well, because CM is that kind of like she does both worlds. She's a harasser on the lane, but can also go jungle with Frostbite. So I'm interested to see if C9 still want to try and run in with the Enigma. It's again another teamfight thing, though. You drop that freezing field with the Darkseer back into a wall, the Naga Siren sets it up. They just need something to hold them there. It could come with Clockwork, but then again, Cogs can also have the opposite effect and push people out.
Well, I mean, the Darkseer and Clockwork are competing the same lane as well, so I think it's going to have to come from elsewhere.
Could you do the Warlock in this game then?
You can. Yeah, the Crystal Maiden makes me want to think that they're actually going for the Carry Naga, because one thing that the Carry Naga really needs is a ton of mana, because she spams Riptide and her illusion so much. So Crystal Maiden with the aura is going to be very helpful in that. Darkseer needs a ton of mana, so it's a very synergistic pick. And here comes Shadow Fiend.
I'm feeling the man of the game has arrived. The Shadow Fiend is finally here. The one guy that doesn't really care, like this is why it has to be, in my mind now, an Enigma, because Naga Siren is the only thing that will control the SF through the BKB. The other option is you go in for like the Bane, but they banned him out in the early stages. They need something that can stop that SF from being a masterful hero during a team fight.
The other way to look at it is how early Cloud9 forces out the BKB on Shadow Fiend. We know Shadow Fiend's going to go for the BKB. It's going to protect him from a lot. Yeah. But let's see if you gank him a couple of times in his laning phase and just make him say, you need the BKB. So suddenly, if you get the BKB as your first core item, by the time where the real fights really happen, you're going to have like a 6-7 second BKB. And by the end of the game, your BKB is just not doing much. So there's a way to combat him that. But, well, I take back what I say about MV Naga, because it seems like we're going to see a support Naga.
You might still be right about the core, Naga Siren core, but I don't know the last time I've seen Sing Sing play the Naga Siren. Because they could still do like the Warlock combo we were talking about. Like just a vacate to the AoE star, and then Luna can go nuts on the Eclipse Glaive bouncing and everything else just flies in. But you run Naga with Sing Sing playing it on the bottom lane, and then you Warlock Luna in the mid. Like that's going to be a lot of damage. I don't see the SF being able to get a lot of control in that lane early on. You get zoned out completely. And you can't really do that with a Naga. But, yeah. Well, C9 are going to get the last pick in a moment. For now, Fnatic, we have one last core hero to get. And this, I'd say this would reveal how our lanes go. You were calling out Tree and Protector going into an aggro try with a Disruptor and Mirana. Would you still be going for that?
I think against a Luna, that would be very, very, very difficult. But now with Storm and Shadow Fiend, who, you know, they both kind of need their own lanes.
Yeah, I think it's going to be aggro try now, or else they won't get the experience, they won't get the farm up on the Storm and the SF. I'd actually push the Storm to the mid and the SF to the top lane to battle up against the Darkseer.
There's an argument of doing a 2-1-2, and you just leave your Treant to pull the safe lane. Because the downside of doing an aggressive trialing on the Dire side is you don't get the jungle pull as you would if you do an aggressive trial on the Radiant side.
But the other downside is like all you really have is Disruptor's Thunderstrike at the very, very start to give you damage, and then he's useless as a support hero on the off lane. All he does is leech experience.
We'll see how Fnatic decides to lane it. I imagine we're going to see Shadow Fiend mid, but safe lane Shadow Fiend and Storm mid will work just fine as well. Either way, though, if Luna goes mid with Cloud9, it's going to be hard for either of these two heroes to lane up against, because her base damage is so much higher.
Well, that's why I kind of want to see the Warlock in there. Welcome to highest base damage you can possibly... Actually, not, he's not the highest base damage. Who actually has the highest base damage? Is it just Tree?
Yeah, I think by a mile.
But Warlock's still pretty far up there.
Yeah, especially if you throw that plus 14 from Luna.
Yeah.
Like, he'll just out-harass from range.
I'm wondering if Paladai wants to do that. If he's just a little bit more concerned about the jump in now from Storm Spirit. Feels like he needs a little bit more control. Because Warlock doesn't really give that. Upheaval doesn't stop the Storm Spirit freely moving around. And he actually goes the OD.
Sing Sing OD, alright?
So that's so the way they do it mid.
Yeah, either way, we're going to see Hani or Storm Spirit being played by Era, seems to say, to get out lane. Or we're going to see Trixie Storm Spirit.
I can't remember the last time I saw Trixie play Storm Spirit, man. Okay. Yeah, and I can't remember the last time I saw Era play Storm Spirit either. Kind of feels like it's been picked into a corner. They got the heroes which they were looking for, but they doubled up a little bit here.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know who, like, the OD pickup, normally you're able to get, like, a counter pick, but when it's the last pickup, and the number 5 pickup by Cloud9, there's no way you could be ready for it.
No.
And you got, you got two Intel heroes, but I don't think this is going to really matter. OD is going to be able to control any hero that comes near her, she'll control her.
I think you need dual lane against it. Remember when Fata got shut down yesterday? He was playing OD mid, and Empire was like, yeah, we'll dual lane you. We'll kill you a couple times.
But
and
what,
he was,
what are you going to throw into the dual lane? Like, you'd have to put Disruptor and SF there. But it's also almost like you have to go SF with Razors first just to try and harass out the OD from the lane in the early stages.
Or just get a couple last hits before your mana gets sucked away.
Yeah, true. Yeah, because how is that supposed to work? Like, you even think about getting it like an aggressive push in. Go for a full-on attack on the SF, on the OD. But you get one raise off if he's got two imprisonments on you. Maybe two.
Yeah. So the argument of getting level 1 raises is such that if you are able to get 2 to 3 last hit on the first wave, or make sure that none of the creeps get denied against you, you get to level 2 instantly. And your shoddy base damage at level 1, you're likely not going to last hit much creep anyways. So getting that quick level 2 and going back to the Necromastery would help you get better last hits. That's the argument of getting raises at level 1. And we'll see if Hani does that. Let's hope that there's no presence of the Dark Lord at 1, because really you want to get that spell.
I remember when that happened once, and Nahaz pulled out a stat saying, I think he said it was 2% of games, presence of the Dark Lord was leveled as first ability.
And I'm sure those are the games where they do level 1 Roche.
Yep. And even then, 2%, I think it's lower than 2%, because 2% is actually quite high for what should happen with the SF. But right now, I'm watching C9 down the bottom lane. You see how aggressively they're moving on the bottom, and also look at the Luna and what he's picked up here. We got Boots first on Eternal Envy.
Standard Envy. Always goes Boots first.
This is Envy thinking exactly what you were talking about. If you're going up against something like Leech Seed, or you're going to have any kind of slow going up against you, you want to be able to move in and out as quickly as possible, keep away from those Fists of the Tree and Protector, so he can't just pound into you.
Yep.
And fight that way. And if, yeah, in fact, they can even run... Oh, are they going to do this? No, the supports will move themselves around. Now he's already got Frostbite and 2 Clarities. He wants to go jungle. But do you remember the era when we just had, it was a fair amount of aggro tri-lanes, but the Lunas used to go solo. It was just a straight-up solo. But one thing I'm noticing Envy's not doing is putting the boots on a courier. Normally he does this when he goes for the run. He puts the boots on the courier because it's a little bit harder with a higher movement speed to get the block.
I see.
Yeah, because now this kind of thing happens. He's trying to like do some fish tails on the Luna.
With the Radiant Wave pushing or running so much quicker, the boots actually helps in the beginning of the block. But yeah, he was able to catch up with it. In any case, the reason you're allowed to get away with this boots first, a lot of other carries, you want to pick up a couple more points in the stats to help you last it better.
Yeah.
But, you know, Luna base damage, insane.
As a Frostbite and Trixie, he's already had to level up Leap and move back down half his life points. You did get the dual lane in mid, but C9 got a DD rune at the very, very start from the Naga Siren. So Fire was being very, very cautious about moving in close. He just got the first Nihilin. The problem is, the more Fly helps out with this, the worse it is for Hani. And he just took up 2 denies then. Like, he's denying up Sing Sing, which is obviously annoying to Sing Sing, but it's just as annoying to Hani. That's the third denial he's taken. And there's only one soul in Hani.
It's not so bad in the sense that Hani will get guaranteed levels. And once you get to level 2 and 3, due to your level up, your damage will come through.
It's guaranteed levels for Hani, but Sing Sing is now here solo. They move Pilot Eye out of the lane. Sing Sing's going to crack level 3 before Hani's able to get even near level 3.
I guess another way to look at it is you pick OD as a lane winner. And he's not winning a lane if you're getting like half your creeps denied.
They're having to play around with Bone 7. He's moving into the tree line so he can just cut his way out here. There's no level up in Glimpse for Notel. But Bone 7 put the Iron Shell up. Because I've actually been watching a lot of Bone 7's play recently with the Darkseer. And one thing he likes to do is wait for something like Notel to come in close. If he didn't have boots on him, he probably would have really given it a crack. But he Iron Shells up and then tries to run down the support hero and just damage him with Iron Shell and base attacks.
I think a lot of supports just underestimate how much damage.
Trixie, possibly dead, depending on where he leaps. Now, Frostbite's there. Pyonite's already moving forward for where he's going to leap. That's why you're seeing him try and go down the river. Those base attacks. He leaps down. The Living Arm will come in. Sing Sing was looking for an imprisonment on the way out. But Trixie copped so much damage for that. At least Hani's able to pick up the Illusion Rune from top.
50 range nerf.
You really like... There's these little things in the game that you just can't give up, can you, Luminous?
No, man. 50 range nerf really took OD away from the mid lane. Like, he used to be picked constantly. And now he's not. But this is actually a very interesting point I want to make. When Speed Gaming won MLG Columbus, RTZ was playing their mid with OD. I remember at the end of the tournament, I had a chance to talk with them, and Sing Sing says, "I don't know how to play OD." So seeing them depict this hero means like he must have practiced sometime in between. And I'm not sure whether he's at the level of Arteezy, but I think this is a big proving game for him.
It's either that or he just says, I'll be fine, and just do like the normal Sing Sing way.
Okay.
You might want to check out Bone 7, dude. He's managed to, like, I don't know if this is a, like, it's just going to be a triple stack. He didn't have time to do a quad. But he's just trying to farm this up with as many Iron Shells as he possibly can. Finally, his level 2 Iron Shell. But he's ripping through this camp rather quickly, while Aoi, for some reason, is now playing the offlane Crystal Maiden. Now, Notel's going to find him. He has a second point up now and actually levels up Glimpse. They're going to drag Aoi back. And Aoi, well, he comes up, and this will be the first blood. With Flyer as well, they have more than enough damage to the right click, and they're trying to give it over to Eero. Fly actually delayed his last attack. While Bone 7... Sorry, I thought for a moment Bone 7 was going to get killed up by the Wild Wing, but he got the timing right for the fullback. But yeah, 1-0 in favor of Fnatic now.
Yeah, despite the unfortunate kill against Crystal Maiden for Cloud9, they actually did an excellent job in shutting down Trixie. Truly, it was a 1v1 lane, Luna versus Mirana in the off lane, but the supports have constantly weaved in and out, preventing Trixie to do anything. Remember, like, Trixie got chased down the river by Crystal Maiden, and yeah, Envy's getting complete free farm. We might see a quick hand of Midas here. It's like 1500 gold hasn't spent any of it.
I wouldn't be surprised, man. He's already so far ahead, and he also realizes coming into this mid game, Hani hasn't really got the greatest start in the world. He's 13 for 3 on this SF up against a 24 for 10 OD. So he's not having to worry about this SF really causing some problems for him early on. Well, Era was also sharing experience up on this top lane, and he doesn't have the items. Like, his money is actually quite good, but he's still going to take another 10 minutes or so before he's really going to start considering rotating around. Now, Pilot Eye, smoke gets revealed, but they're coming in for mid. Surge over on Pilot Eye. He just goes for the Riptide, now into the snare. Trixie leaps away, Living Arm protects him. OD imprisons up the SF, wants to keep him out of this fight. Lead seats on Pilot Eye. Frostbite keeping Fly away. Pilot Eye, one last attack from Hani, will get the kill, but he's completely out of mana. Aoi dragged back by the Glimpse, and there's four heroes from Fnatic trying to fight this bottom, this middle lane, while OD on the front lines is loving this. Three imprisonments now being used. He's got a lot of mana behind him, and Eternal Envy is still farming up bottom lane.
Yeah, unfortunately here for Sing Sing is...
He's doing Mask of Madness first? You greedy Luna.
Mask of Madness is kind of like Midas if you think about it. It's just a great farming item. Yes, it will punish you if you use it incorrectly, but I guess Envy has a lot of confidence in that. Here we go. One thing that Mask of Madness doesn't do a lot better than a Hand of Midas is give you the mobility as well. If you sense a gank coming in, you run out of there with that Mask of Madness.
Top lane, this movement coming in. Pilot Eye, he gets a Riptide over on Eero, but with support coming in from Notel, there's enough burst damage to ensure the Naga Siren was going to go down. He attempted to come in for the denial, but he also got the initial damage over on the Storm Spirit. So I thought he was doing a good job. But yeah, Envy's going to town, this bottom tower. Sees Trixie, one Lucent Beam, down to one third of his life points.
Yeah, I'm actually quite concerned for Fnatic at this point. Despite getting 3 kills, as well as a tier 1 tower, look at Trixie's level. He's going to crack level 3 and perhaps 4 in just a bit. But he's just been a non-factor. And the last couple games we've been seeing is a Luna that's getting farmed, and the Luna that's getting... Or sorry, a Mirana that's going to get a lot of farm.
They're going to go on Aoi. Ira's pulling him back. The wall will come up. And Aoi just as much damage as he possibly can to Ira before death. Yeah. Another death.
Aoi's doing a very good job keeping Fnatic farmed, leveled.
He's keeping him entertaining. Keeping him entertained. Just play with the Crystal Maiden for a little while, kids. The adults will be back soon. This OD, man, is still getting really... Like, the OD and the Luna for me are the scariest things in the world. Like, SF, Hani is finally getting what he was searching for. Stacks. Like, inside the jungle, this is that flash farming you get from the Shadow Fiend. Are you noticing, too, that Hani is not subscribing to the Hand of Midas SF in this game? Doesn't really feel the desire for it.
He's preaching to the wrong gods, man.
Oh, yeah, I think I remember Hani actually speaking kind of roughly out against the SF Hand of Midas.
Yeah, there's different arguments of... Because if you're really getting a Midas to delay already, you're very good farming. Like, why do you need a Midas? You already farm so fast already.
Yeah.
So there's an argument against that, but hey.
It's like the double injection of money. I remember there was someone I was casting with, and it was either... It might have been Clairvoyance that was debating it. And basically said that it was a good idea, because some people just forget the attack speed from the Hand of Midas as well. So at least you're pulling that out, and you're double flash farming in a way.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the other way. I think it was him that was trying to sell it.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah. A little bit of dewarding coming out from AEI. The critical thing for me is that he's able to get a lot of experience running around. Again, he has more experience, or close to Mirana's experience on the offlane. Looks like Mirana has overtaken him at this point. And as a Crystal Maiden, being able to stay effective, he's trying to stay effective in a different way. He's doing the aura route. Not much ganking, just making sure that, you know, OD is stocked with mana. Same thing with Luna. Same thing with support Naga.
At some point, though, they have to get these supports some extra farm. Like, you look at the net worth, and there's only two heroes that are sub 1,000. And that's Crystal Maiden and the Naga. Sorry, now on bottom lane, Trixie leaps away. Ensnare will fly out. Is there... Well, they don't have to pop Eclipse for this one. Trixie will get a decent arrow off. Envy takes a lot of damage because he's got the Mask of Madness up. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, they're jumping in a Bone 7. Ira will get the pullback. So it's actually a 2-for-2 trade with the Darkseer and the OD going down for the Mirana and the Dream Protector. And it looks like Aoi's just trying to keep him off the tower.
Yeah, losing two core and possibly even losing the third. Envy was so close to dying. If the tower actually shot him, he would have been dead. So, really close call for Cloud9, but they are losing a ton of ground here. If they lose this tier 1 tower, this is going to give Storm a lot more room to get those kills. And Storm's weaving around. Got to be careful.
Oh, Frostbite's already on him. He might get imprisoned up quickly. The wall is trying to keep him away from this mid tower, but both OD and Aoi attack it at the same time. Ira comes back to the World of Living Beast. Got 442 mana pool. After one imprisonment. What is this hero meant to do during a team fight? If he jumps in and gets imprisoned straight away, there's hardly anything left once he pops off a Remnant as well as a Vortex.
Yeah, fortunately for him, I guess, quote-unquote, Erico, fortunately, is that your ultimate takes a percentage of your mana pool. So if you have a small mana pool, it's not going to take too much. But unfortunately, you know, Remnants and Electric Vortex, they all take the same amount. A lot.
Surge is coming up. Ira, he's got one possible jump. He's still actually affected by the imprisonment from before. So he doesn't have that much mana to play with, even though he said like percentage-wise, but still.
Yeah.
Not that as great. But the Darkseer can't find any kind of real opening because they're back to middle lane. Pulled back into the ultimate and Sing Sing. He wants to imprison himself right now. One charge is anything he had to try and keep himself alive. But with the SF ulti being committed, they were able to find just enough damage to kill him off before that happened.
Yeah, they're doing such a good job shutting down that OD. Again, something that we talked about yesterday is that when the OD loses his lane, what does he do during the mid game? He doesn't flash farm, he doesn't jungle, he doesn't push towers. So it's hard for OD to recover.
Ira, he's jumping on Pylai Dai. There's a split out right now, and Darkseer is coming in with the Iron Shell. Ira, he's still got another jump away. He goes east, but he's down to one third of his life points, and Bone 7 is kind of half sticking around. Surge is out, and Pylai wants just a TP out. that's experienced in middle lane. Bonesiven will do the same thing. So Flying Era will find nothing, and Harney's rotated up here for very little. You talked about that BKB timing. Yeah, Trixie's running away on bottom, but with that Mask of Madness triggered up from Envy, he should not overcommit. Oh my, no, that's 4 points Glimpse, man. They're dragging him back the whole way, and now he can't even go in for the full Eclipse. He's trying to get a Lucid Beam to kill off Trixie, but very quickly, Fnatic brought the support down to punish the greedy Envy.
Yeah, I think the underestimation of what No-Tail can do with that Glimpse has really cost Cloud9 multiple kills. In fact, I think all of the kills really started with a good Glimpse back.
Well, Bonesiven, he's in trouble being pulled in, but then again, Era's taking so much damage, and Bonesiven, he needed some extra burst damage to ensure the Storm Spirit went down. So he actually dropped the wall, and that's Bonesiven getting a solo kill on a Storm Spirit.
And that should not happen.
He can't afford to have that happen either. This guy's trying to build a Lincoln Sphere on the Storm Spirit. It's either that or it's just a casual Ring of Health.
It can't be a casual Ring of Hell, right? Because you really slow down your Orchid timing. Orchid's one of the best item for Storm Spirit to go in and go for a kill, but yeah, he's going to go for the defensive route. Very early defensive item coming out from Fnatic, the BKB we talked about in Shadow Fiend. Just want to echo my point I brought up earlier. The earlier BKB is, great, you can fight right now, but as the game approached like the 35 to 40 minute mark, your BKB is going to get weaker, and that's when things like Hexes coming out from Sing Sing. That's when, you know, Luna could trade right clicks with you and drop Eclipse on your head. So I am a little bit worried for Hani down the road.
Yeah, I'm with you on it, man. Right now, we're just going picturesque shot. Just check out the OD's animation when he's halfway through it. ways to kill off the towers. The man who was currently DC'd out. I'm surprised that there's actually been so many DCs from Sing Sing of late.
Yeah.
I think something's happened to his computer recently, but he has no problem when he's streaming. Just during competitive games, the toll on the computer is higher. And I'm watching
Have other things open up in his monitor.
On second screen? Is that hentai stopped playing?
Sing Sing's very vocal about his anime hate, but let's be real. Let's be real, Sing Sing.
Is it rather still amusing that he's playing with Eternal Envy then? And also on top of that, Cloud9 is actually basically a hentai group. I mean, an anime group, not a hentai.
Well, they are sponsored by anime.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
So they kind of got to accept that.
Well, maybe why that's like Sing Sing's computer slow down. Working that Crunchyroll in the background, watching them VODs of anime.
He was given a task. Eternal Envy sat there and said, okay, training session, boys, training session. Today, we're starting off with episode 1 of Bleach. We'll watch Naruto Shippuden in just a couple of moments' time, and then we'll have an exam on Digimon. Good luck.
I do not subscribe to those animes. And I don't think Envy does either.
I don't think Envy would subscribe to Digimon. And I think everyone's watched it at one point, but then you watch both Beyblade and Digimon, and you go, wait, this is exactly the same. The names are exactly the same. The storyline is actually exactly the same. It's just put in a different world. Just in case people didn't really work out that the guy who has issues but is part one of the nice guys is always called Kai.
That's rough.
Yeah, especially for Hani, whose name is Kai.
Well, he doesn't have much issue this game. BKB coming up 2-0-3. Good farming coming from him.
Mm-hmm.
Aaron might have some issue up top, but he's a Storm, which is a really hard catch.
Yeah, but then with an OD imprisonment, like, I know they're not going to, like, ensnare his... they can Riptide him, and then Era, well, with Frostbite, he jumps himself away. He's burned through a lot of his mana pool, but he's underneath this tier 1 tower, so he's safe.
Yep.
But it's still more farm coming in for Sing.
Luna has enjoyed absolute free farm, apart from that one gank that came against him, that Mask of Madness. Whether you want to call that a Hanamitis or a feeding item?
I would call it the feeding item early on, considering he almost died to the tier 1 tower when they tried to dive in for the kill, and then he did die to the Fnatic lineup when he was going in deeper. Like, you need to have the BKB to work. Like, that's why I was kind of okay with the Hanamitis with the Mask of Madness before, because he had the BKB to protect him. But now with the Hanamitis going, with the Hanamitis, now you've got me calling Mask of Madness Hanamitis. With the Mask of Madness this time around, it's just completely raw.
Hey, man. If you're fighting just PvE, Mask of Madness, best item in the game.
Dude, Gordon Ramsay would not approve.
Look, man, he knows. Envy says, hey, No-Tail, you want to gank me bottom? Which, by the way, No-Tail is just hiding. Like, if he sees Envy walk past this point, he's going to Thunderstrike, get a TP in, glimpse, and they're going to get a kill. Yep. Envy's having none of that.
No,
so I don't see No-Tail, man.
Envy just wants towers, man. They group up. This is now the point where C9 should be sitting there going, we're so much better at team fighting. Let's just do that.
Oh, man, don't get Thunderstruck, Envy. Yep. Get out of there.
There it is.
Oh,
the ulti's caught three. Pylon O will stop it, though. They've got to walk themselves out of the Static Storm. But Bone 7, he's checking around. The wall to drop down. And it's only No-Tail you get a copy of. The Moonlight Shadow will protect Fnatic as they reinitiate in here. The Mega Charge to go and the Leech Seed. Fly just gets nuked down. Pylon die. Envy, he did a really good job with his Eclipse. But now the extra support. Here is in there. We're actually losing everyone left, right, and center. Three down for C9, about to be four. Bone 7 dying up the ramp. Storm Spirit quickly able to jump in. But that Moonlight Shadow, it's like C9 didn't know who to attack because they couldn't see him. They dropped the Sentry Ward down, but it was so far back.
Envy basically waited under the tier 1 tower for the TPs to come in because it's like, oh, you're TPing in. My Eclipse is ready. But they TP in Invis, and Envy was confused. So, and then the rest of C9 was confused. It was a great counter initiate, but fighting under the enemy tier 1 tower like that gave Fnatic a very easy route of reinforcement, and I don't think Cloud9 was expecting that.
Well, right now Fnatic have just pushed themselves into a wonderful advantage. As I bring up the gold graph for the first time in the experience graph, it was pretty level until that point, and that one fight, 2.5k experience advantage goes the way of Fnatic, and roughly 2k gold advantage also comes their way. Perfect fight. The one thing, though, that I'm not seeing Fnatic really capitalizing on, which is what C9 was capable of doing in the last game, was Roshan. Now, I know they don't really have enough of the damage right now. We've only just got to a point where Hani has a point up in presence of the Dark Lord. So they don't really have the negative armor to play around with for Roshan. But they're going to need to get to a point soon where they can go in and take advantage of that. And they're already trying to take advantage by killing off the OD. Trixie moves around the side. Storm Spirit jumps in. Sing Sing, he won't survive this. The arrow will connect. They had Pylon die as well as Owl in the neighborhood, but there was no Song of the Siren, and there really isn't much more that CM can do. They're waiting for Envy to finish his farming. It's taking so long to get that BKB up. And he can't even kill off the tier 1 tower. There's no injection of gold coming from tier 1 towers.
No. Like, he's really, really afraid of No-Tail. Like, No-Tail's really the single person that'll kill him repeatedly, and at this point, Era could kill him solo as well, especially if that Mask of Mana gets turned on. Here comes the Siege at tier 2 top, and Cloud9, well, they don't have the Song to actually prevent any combos, so they're gonna just give up a tower for free.
Yep.
Another reason why these tier 1s are not falling for Fnatic is this Tree Protector. The tower, every time you don't see them, they're at 4 HP.
Yeah, middle one's already regenerating up. He's got some work to do on the top tower, but with the lane that's pushed out this far, mid and bottom are the ones under pressure. You're right. And how is C9 meant to really take the towers? They don't really have a lineup where you go, tower damage is wonderful. Like, Luna is the only one that can technically do it, and that's where their ability to nuke down the creep wave. Sing Sing cannot. This OD, he does nothing to towers. Crystal Maiden and Pylon Eye are in the same boat. And Pylon Eye, I think, is just hoping at one point he can get more than brown boots and a basic stick. This guy isn't even a wizard. He's a first-year student.
You know, you were talking about the Roshan happening. If you could keep up all your tier 1 towers, Roshan becomes significantly easier if you're the dire side.
Mm-hmm.
And I think those towers are going to be alive for a while.
Well, it's going to take time before C9 is ready to push out and fight. And I'd say the time is the BKB recipe for Luna. That's the time frame I'm looking at here for C9. Like, OD has that much time to find as much farm out of the bottom, or the mid and the top, and as much of the jungle as he's allowed to have, that Envy won't take from him.
Mm-hmm.
And in the meantime, we're seeing Hani getting more and more. What's that coming in? He's got Helm of the Dominator, as well as having BKB. At this point, Hani, if he gets a DD rune, he can solo Roshan. An 18-minute rune is going to be, it's DD, but it's on top.
Yeah. I mean, I think if they just want Hani to solo Roshan, he already can. If you want to just invest a whole bunch of living armor for him, you can kind of just kite it back and forth. But obviously, meanwhile, you lose a lot of ground on your other lanes. And here we go, Era, trying to slow that push.
How are they meant to kill Era on the top lane?
They don't.
Because he just jumps away. Instead, doesn't control him. There's the Odium Imprisonment. Now, Pylite die. He's waiting for the time. Frostbite, nothing. Era just jumps himself away. But they'll take the tier 1 tower. That's all they're looking at. But it's a trade-off. Hani and Fly are already taking out the bottom tower. Fortifications protecting the top tower. Living armor, still available. And there's TPs coming in. Three TPs. They come in with the pyramid and Hani imprisoned up, but again they're using the Moonlight Shadow as they come in here. They don't see Fly. Arrows come out. Sing Sing, he's trapped inside the Static Storm, but then again Naga stops everything with that Song of the Siren, and now is TPing out. Sing Sing has to move faster. Envy comes around the side and sees Trixie. I don't know why he was running in that far. Hero will get the pullback. He's got Eclipse available, but he doesn't want to use it because he's dead already. SF gets just the medium range with a basic attack with a Starfall damage from Trixie. Envy loses his life instantly. And Glimpse. Now, glimpsing Sing Sing back. He's back into... Wait, he imprisoned
himself. Astro.
He imprisoned himself, but yep. SF just winds up the ulti to kill him. This is a flawless game from Fnatic in this. But at the same time, C9, they're in a position where they keep getting picked off.
Yeah, normally Cloud9 are really good at doing these kind of rat Dota, but Dota... damaging a tier 1 tower like this does not matter against a Treant. Mm-hmm. And Treant is knocking at your front door.
I still just have trouble finding ourselves in this position. Like, Hani didn't have a great start. OD had a wonderful start. But Hani just goes back, he flash farms up a little bit. Trixie got completely destroyed in the early stages. And then they get a couple of kills in the bottom lane. They bring down the Luna. Hani gets his more farm, like more of his farm, and C9 attempt two different ganks over on Era, who does exactly that. He gets Lucent Beam, pulled in, and then just ulties himself away. It's like, who is C9 meant to be ganking right now? Because every time they try and do it on SF, he's got two heroes around him. And whenever they do it on Trixie, he's normally got living armor from global support anyway. And now we got observers and sentries inside the base of C9. Fnatic have every bit of intel they're required to take this fight. Now Storm Spirit jumps in, dragging Sing Sing back, Starfall, Bone Seven's already dead. Sing Sing out inside the tree ulti, Envy, he pumps off his own ultimate right now, but he's doing minimal to no damage to any of the core heroes of Fnatic, and the double buybacks coming out from C9, and they're still trying to kill off Fly, while Envy, he's battling up against Era, and Era wins the fight. Now he has to basically let it go to bring down the mid Storm Spirit, but that's for a Storm Spirit who has Bloodstone charges. So he's already back alive again, and they got the Luna down.
Three death on core heroes, buyback on two of your cores, and you just get a storm and a tree. I think a large part of Fnatic's success is No-Tail. If you look at his score right now, he's 2-0-14. He's participated in 16 of the 18's kill. And the bigger issue right now is you got the acceptor finish. So your BKB on Luna, you might not even get to activate it. If you're within the Static Storm, you can't play or you can't activate your items. It's like an AoE Doom. That's just one more worry that Cloud9 has on top of them. This game is looking very, very difficult.
Yeah. It's getting worse and worse for C9 as it goes on. They're now almost 10,000. Actually, it's just hovering around the 7.5k experience gold average. Being the difference, Bone 7's coming in. They're trying to stop Roshan from being done back, but there was no one left inside the pool. Hani moves back, and again, the Moonlight Shadow makes them wonder where everyone is. The Sentry Wall will come down, but it's too late. Sing Sing's been dragged back in again. Storm Spirit's already got the kill here. Back up to 8 Bloodstone charges, and back up the hill. The arrow, it hits on Pylai, die full 5 seconds. Now, Envy's come into this, but there's no Eclipse. Pylai's walking out of here, but now it's going to wear off. And Era, he just jumps in. Vortex, 2 seconds away, doesn't even require it. Chases him the old-fashioned way. And Bone7's gone AWOL up to the Secret Shop of Fnatic.
Yeah, the Storm pick has really made Cloud9 pay. They just have no way to deal with that Storm. Mm-hmm. Apart from Storm running out of mana, that's how Era only died in that engagement.
But Mini can't run out of mana at this point. Like, even if OD imprisoned him, he's only going to get one imprisonment off. The Blossom does basically... everything else, and there goes Aoi. Boom.
Yeah. I mean, in the previous fight, Storm ran out of mana chasing
and Bone 7. Glimpse down into the wall, and he's locked in here. And that's Bone 7 dead. That'll be Roshan dead. I wouldn't be surprised if Cloud9 is considering just calling... Wait, they have a Darksteer wall that's causing him some problems here. So they drag Roshan out first. But I wouldn't be surprised if Cloud9 is, like, hovering the finger over the G button. Ear is about to jump top lane. He's searching for Envy. There's no BKB on Envy. So Ear has the advantage here. Even with the ulti coming off, he's vortexing it back in again. Ear's got so much life points, he's able to survive this. He just solos up the Luna. And the Aegis Immortal goes into Hani with 3.9k gold. This guy is now building a butterfly over on the SF. I can't remain Mr. Positive here.
It didn't help that Mask of Madness was turned on.
No. No, it didn't. Quick chat trivia before we end this. Who are the only three heroes with an active ability that is used 150 plus times on average each pro Dota 2 match?
So, you spam a lot.
Yeah. I'm going to say Tree Living Armor.
Sure.
And I'm pretty sure Nahas put that one in there just because it's possible.
I mean, there's a lot, right? Like, for example, I'm thinking Tinker is up there.
Oh, yeah, Tinker, because he's just, like, rearming the entire time. But then again, it's...
And heroes that drag games out?
Nature's Prophet.
Naga Siren, I'm looking at you.
Naga Siren, Mirror Images, yeah.
Or Riptide, you know?
Considering there's so many options here, I'm pretty sure this is now going to be a bit of more of a bait.
About Bristleback?
Bristleback Quills?
Except I don't think he's picked a lot, so I don't know if it's... Who knows?
Bristleback would have to be one of them.
Raises count as a one spell? Like, you know, all three of them combined to one? It's probably Shadowfiend.
I don't think he pops them off enough, though.
Yeah.
Like, Templar Assassin Refraction, I'd also throw up there. There's just so many options for this. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. D1 is coming out. C90 going blind on the map. We got a gem on the Disruptor. No tell. It looks like he doesn't care about sentry wards. He's just walked past two sentry wards and just not cared. He's left them standing.
I'll be fine.
Maybe you just want to make sure the Trixie will be safe on the bottom lane. Meanwhile, up on top lane, smoke movement. Era jumps up and he goes straight on bone 7. The Moonlight Shadow will protect him again. Harney, one race, a little bit too far off with the mech. Leech Seed, we've got another jump and the blink into a tree ulti from Fly. There is no way bone 7 was going to survive that. But luckily, Envy moves back and finally, this is going to be the last thing. If Envy loses a fight with the BKB, this game is over. Just on a mental approach, but if he can win it with a BKB, game is back on like Donkey Kong.
Here's the thing though, like, can he even activate the BKB? It goes back to the whole Acceptor Static Storm.
Is it? Oh, true. It
prevents activation from items.
If he can get it up before that, but then again,
no. I don't even think he can get it off. Let's be real. I think Storm's going to zip in. They're going to lock him down.
There he goes, Pilot. I die with a Storm zip. And Pilot, I, if he ulties, he can get himself away, but he doesn't want to put that thing on cooldown. This is just... It's getting to a point where it's painful. Top lane, Honey just goes in. Range ranks, why not? Storm Spirit's here as well. They got no Naga Sleep to give him the cover fire. Darkseer's got no straightway in. Sing Sing, he just got glimpsed back from wherever he was. And Envy comes in. One Lucent Beam, but Hero doesn't care about this. He's regenerating at 56.3 a second when he uses that bottle charge. He's already looking very, very healthy. An Invoker. Okay, Quaswex, Exorcist counts. You're right about the Bristleback. And Poof? Well, I suppose because you're doing it with duels. Sing Sing, Drink Drank back, and there is your Storm. And you're right, BKB will never even come. This will be Rax getting destroyed right now. There's Frostbite over on Era. But there's no way to contain him. No way to hold him. He's got 15 seconds as well over on... 15 Bloodstone charges. The Biomech comes down from Sing Sing. Naga Sleep is all they can really do. Try and set themselves up. They've lost their top Rax. Notel probably the major one they try and bring down. Harney as well, if they can get him. BKB from Harney. OD back in. But then again, Notel, he's running away from all of these illusions. Bone 7 wants to keep up with him. Notel will actually... Well, yeah, he will. Living Armor's protecting him. GG. Actually, it's just the G from Envy. This was only a game.
This was not a good game for Cloud9, to say the least. I think it really came down to the draft. The two supports were unable to kill.
But is that really coming down the draft? Because we were sitting there at the draft going, well, the lanes should still work. And the lanes did. The lanes really did work.
Yeah.
They just didn't transition into anything. Are you saying it's just the draft because of the Storm Spirit?
Well, draft and their mid game. I think the way that they laned it, Trixie had level 2 when Crystal Maiden was level 4. Like, that's... superb offlane control. Not many other team could do that. And then they just got ganked by level 4 Glimpse all day long. No tell my MVP for the game. Not even close.
Yeah. Agreed. He was the most influential hero on the map. And we're saying that with, like, SF walking around with 6-1-13. Mr. Storm Spirit, he went 15-2-7 on Hero. Yeah, this is a game that Cloud9 will like to forget. And maybe they'll like to remember the next game. Because if they don't win this one, they're down into the playoff bracket. And we may even just have ourselves a C9 versus Empire for the last slot. Right now, Fnatic are looking one game victory away from joining Team Dog as the second team to qualify for ESL One Frankfurt. Will it be them, or will we see a Game 5? Stay tuned and we'll find out.